piano day! It's piano day. It's piano day. Hey, hello everybody. Welcome back. Today is day 28. 28 days of doing this, and we'll have more. Yes, we will, because that's what we're doing. It's a pleasure to see you. We've done the best we could with this new technology in this room, so I hope you enjoy it. It will probably change next week. That's just what we do, because we really have nothing else to do. I'd like to thank my crew, my lighting crew, my producer, Linda, my lighting crew, Linda, my grip, Linda, my... I'm having a little fling with the production assistant, Linda. We've been having a good time setting this all up for you. And it's been fun. Like I said, going back and, you know, stop giggling. What? I made her giggle. I know. The daughter's here, so, you know, we're having lots of fun now. New people to talk to. And, okay. So I'm so happy to be here with you. I hope you're doing okay. I know there's a 18-year-old, got a birthday in Wichita, Kansas. It's got to be hard. All the folks that are missing their, all the young folks that are missing their graduations and their birthdays. But well, this will be one to remember, that's for sure. And, you know, the feelings in your heart. Just love to you all. Oh, I could just go on and on and on. So piano day. Let's do a song from the album of the same name. It's a little 4th Street feeling. Now, 4th Street is the street in my hometown of Leavenworth, Kansas. And it's kind of like the main drag, you know, the one that... Yeah, the one that you ride up and down on. It takes maybe 10 minutes to go from one end to the other. Maybe 15 if you go really slow and stuff. But, you know, the A&W drive-in was there. Just kind of the place that we would kind of go back and forth when we were bored on the weekend. And when I was making this album, I was getting very nostalgic. Very reminiscent. This is about 10 years ago, probably. Maybe less, maybe 9-8 years ago. But it was an interesting time for me. And so I... I wrote a little song about remembering and being nostalgic and wanting to go back, and called it 4th Street Feeling. There's something I'm not talking about. The whispers have found me behind the shadows of my doubts. I get the feeling that everything I'm doing now, I'm doing wrong. Everybody's known all along. So take me away, way back to that 4th Street feeling now, when everything I had, I could fit into my Chevrolet. We all good? The sweet smell of summer sin. Oh. I get the feeling that everything I'm doing now, I'm doing wrong. And everybody's known all along, so take me away. way back to that 4th Street feeling now. Everything I had, I could fit into my Chevrolet. It was perfect and strange, living life with that 4th Street feeling now. Who am I to think I could just run away? Did we have a problem? What happened? Well, you could. Is it just is it drifting?
It's drifting.
It's drifting. Why don't you? Yeah, do your camera person's got to just hold them. Hold it. Okay. We good? I'd like to thank my crew. but it's all good. It's all good. It's been fun sort of checking out all these piano songs and kind of going back in memories and figuring stuff out. This next song, when I was remembering it, I hadn't thought about this in a long time. This is from Your Little Secret, and it is the last song on Your Little Secret. And I was remember writing it, and this was, I was writing it in 94, in the fall of 94. And I wrote it for a friend's funeral. It was Raul Julia. He had done a film with my good friend Laura Dern. Laura Dern comes up a lot in these, doesn't she? But she had done a film called Down Came a Blackbird. It was a really intense film about torture survivors and, love. And it was just a really intense film. I think you can still find it on something and watch it. But during the making of the film, Raul Julia had been sick. He had cancer. And he died 2 weeks after they closed production. And when it was time to do his memorial, Laura asked me if I would write a song, in memory of him. And the subject of, the film they had made, the heaviness of the film they had made about, the some darkness that was in South America and these places, and then, then just the heaviness of him transitioning and moving on, it really led to the heaviness of this song. So I did that, and then when I was recording Your Little Secret just after that, I remember it was one of the last songs we recorded because I wasn't sure if I wanted to record it because it was so heavy and so dark. And so I did. And I remember, if you hear the recording, Mark Brown puts that just amazing bass part in it. And I remember it was a very slow, it was a very dirge of a song. You know, a dirge is like a funeral song that is just so slow. And then in the end, I said, then I want to break into, twice as fast, and I want to kick it up and kind of celebrate it out. And so that's how we did the recording. And I used to, in 95, I used to end the shows with this. This used to be the encore. And I remember I would walk off first, and then John, and then it would be just the bass and the drums playing, and then Kenny would play, and then it would just be Mark playing on the bass like he had started it, and he would just walk off stage. It was one of my favorite ways that we began and ended a concert. And then, once I put it on the album, my friend at the time, yes, he was a very close friend, Brad Pitt, I had seen him in Ireland when he was filming another film called The Devil's Own. And he brought this song to the director and producer and said, why don't we put this as the ending credits for that film? So kind of going from one film experience and actor to another, this then is the going over the ending credits of The Devil's Own. So there you go. This is a song called This War Is Over. Anymore. slow. I won't fight here anymore. Tell them I'm all right. I'm coming home. Tell them I'm all right. I am alone. This war is over. And then boom, dum, boom, 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 boom. Then we play and sing. I haven't done that in many years. After all that about the water, I didn't bring my water here. Oh, well. I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm good. You can't leave because it will start swimming. Yes, and we don't want that. We don't want to make the viewers at home dizzy. I'm fine. No, sorry. Yeah, I'm good. I'm good, I'm good, I'm good. But you at home, drink your water. Drink some water. Drink it. Are you taking your walks? Are you keeping your everything sane? How's my wife? What's up, honey?
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter. I know I was going to say that for those of you celebrating Easter. Happy Easter.
How am I?
What's that? Okay. Everything, how's my crew doing? Everybody good? All right. Everybody at home good? Home. So many places. Oh, reaching out to Northern Ireland, Belfast, saying hi to you. Thank you so much. I do. I mentioned Scotland and England, and Ireland is also in the house watching. And of course, my morning friends in Australia and New Zealand. Of course, Europe. Late at night over there. And then America and Canada and Hawaii and all the places that we are staying home, trying not to go crazy. It's a little, in our neighborhood, it's a little Truman Show. We walk outside and it's like the same people are there walking. And it's like we all walk at the same time. So it's a little weird. So we try to mess it up a bit and walk at different times. But, we're all doing what we can. Make sure you're eating healthy. Make sure you're thinking healthy. Oh, I got so many requests for this. And when I was doing this today, I was thinking, ooh, yesterday was so much fun with Janis Joplin Day. I think we need to do a Bruce Springsteen Day. Yeah, I think we do. And since this was on the piano, I'll just do this Bruce Springsteen song on the piano. Got many requests for it. And, I get to tell you my Bruce Springsteen experience. On Bruce Springsteen Day, I will tell you many more stories, but I'll tell you just this one of how I had met him a couple times, at the Grammys and stuff like that, and said hello, and he was very nice. But in 94, MTV reached out to me and said, we want you to do an Unplugged. I was very excited because that was very big back then. And I said, yes, I do. And they said, well, is there anyone you want to sing with, maybe do a duet with? So there's only one that is like my number one, and I thought, why not ask? I certainly didn't expect it to happen, but I said, Bruce Springsteen. They said, well, we'll call and get back to you. And the next day, they got back to me and said, he said yes. And that just, that got me all nervous and everything. But my Unplugged, I believe that my Unplugged should be truly unplugged. Some people kind of played with a band anyway. But it was just me and my guitar. And I had done that for so long, for so many years, that I was very comfortable playing unplugged. And obviously, some of you have seen my solo shows. What's up, honey?
Low battery.
No!
What do we do?
What do we do with a low battery?
We could take it off and come back on. I wonder if it would.
Oh, shoot.
That's why it's the shot chain.
Oh,
and it won't. Yeah, okay.
Make sure.
We're back. Yeah, we're good.
Oh, man. Things like, I don't know, batteries.
I'm going to plug it in. I'm like, thanks.
What's that? I want to make sure people are commenting that I'm definitely back on.
We're good?
We're good, says my daughter. Okay. All right. Yeah, okay. We'll get things that we need to make sure. We're good? Okay. I was telling you a Bruce Springsteen story before everything went black. All right, we're back. Oh, I should have got water when I was up. No, I'm good. I'm good. Oh, okay. Come on in, daughter. Are you good? Thank you. Ah! Wow. Thank you so much. Where was I? If you ever wondered if this was live, you know. Very live. All right, so Bruce Springsteen said yes, and I was doing my unplugged, totally just me and my guitar. So Bruce came earlier that day, and we were up in a it was at the Brooklyn Music Conservatory or something, that's what it's called there in Brooklyn. We were filming it there, and we were up in the rehearsal rooms. It was just me and him on guitar and going through this song, and you know the song by now, it's Thunder Road. And we were practicing it, and it was so funny. In the middle of it, he went, you know, this song doesn't have a chorus. And I said, yeah, I thought you meant to do it that way. He goes, no. He goes, it's just a bunch of lyrics. I said, yeah, but they're really good lyrics. And he's like, yeah, okay. And then we went down to run through it to do a rehearsal. And he walked out, and he goes, where's your band? And I said, there's no band, it's just me and you on guitars. And he was like, oh, really? This was before he had done his Tom Joad tour. He had never really, done it like that before. And it was really exciting. And during the rehearsals, I made a big deal. I wanted to sing the last line. I wanted to sing, because I was just all new, out, big gay Melissa. Just, you know, like months before that, you know, I had... I hadn't been out very long, and I was singing all these songs about women that I'd always wanted to sing, but always felt uncomfortable without being out. And so I said, please, can I sing So Mary Climb In? I just wanted to sing So Mary Climb In, and then we would both join together and sing the last line. Well, I kept forgetting to come in. I made the big deal that I wanted to sing that line, and I kept forgetting in rehearsal. I was like, okay, I got to do it. So then when we taped it and he came out and I sang it, it was a great take, and I didn't come in on Mary Climb, totally busted the take, and we had to do the song all over again. And so if you watch the video, it's on YouTube and it's been watched a lot. If you see on YouTube at the very end, you'll see him smile and kind of go like this, because it looks like I'm going to blow it again. And I step right, it's like I miss a beat, but I step up and go, So Mary Climb In. And so if you're wondering why Bruce laughs at the end, that's why it is, because I was so enthralled with listening to him sing and singing with him that I just couldn't get it together to do that. But finally did, and we took it, and there's the take forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. So I'm going to do this for you, the whole song. Like I said, of all the Springsteen songs, I didn't do this one much when I was young, because it was definitely singing about Mary, and knowing my little secret, I didn't want to, you know, let anybody know. So I didn't really do this much. So I've only done this a handful of times. But oh my gosh, this is one of my favorite songs by Bruce. You know, his piano player, Roy Bataan, just playing... just making all those... Nobody plays like him. Oh. The screen door slams, Mary's dress waves. Like a vision, she dances across the porch as the radio plays. face myself alone again. Don't you run back inside, darling, you know just what I'm here for. So you're scared and you're thinking that maybe we ain't that young anymore. So little faith is magic in the night. You ain't a beauty, but hey, you're all right. Oh, and it's all right with me. You can hide neath your covers and study your pain. Make crosses of your lovers, throw roses in the rain. Waste your summer praying in vain for a savior to rise from these streets. Understood. All the redemption I can offer, girl, is beneath this dirty hood. With a chance to make it good somehow, tell me what else can we do now? Except roll down the window and let the wind roll back your hair. You know the night's busting open, these two lanes will take us. Some wheels climbing back, heaven's waiting on down the track. Oh, oh, come take my hand. Our bus is not tonight to chase the promised land. Oh, 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 Thunder Road, oh, Thunder Road, oh, Thunder Road. It's lying out there like a killer in the sun. Front porch to my front seat. The door's open, but the ride ain't free. I know you're ready for words that I ain't spoke. Tonight, our promises will be broken, and there were ghosts in the eyes of all the boys that just sent away. They haunt this dusty beach road in the skeleton frames of burned out Chevrolet. Graduation gown lies in rags at their feet. And in the lonely cool before the dawn, you hear their engines roaring along. When you get to the porch, they're gone on the wind. So merry climbing. It's a town full of losers. We're pulling out of here to win. Still got, we're still on?
Rumor has it.
What's that?
Rumor has it.
Rumor has it. We're still going. People are still watching. Oh, all right. One more song. Fun doing piano day. We'll do daughter duet day. That's coming. And then all week, 3 o'clock, right here, 3 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, 6 o'clock on the East Coast, so you can make your dinner. I hope you're having a great Easter or whatever, you know, you might be just having just a lovely Sunday. Even in these crazy times, I can always tell Sundays. Sundays are just different. Right? Right. How are you doing, honey, my love, behind the camera?
I hope I don't get fired.
I can't fire you. I got nobody else.
thank you.
No, you're fantastic. Oh, we'll be back in the guitar room tomorrow and playing songs. I got this one last song for you to do, and I rarely do this song. This song, I wrote this song when I was actually on chemo. It was, I put it on my Greatest Hits album. And it's a song about being on chemo or in any sort of challenge that someone might have that is very personal. I know when I was on chemo, I would, they would give it to me, and it was called Dose Dense because I didn't have to work and I didn't have to do anything, so they could put as much of it in me as they could, and it would just take me really, really low, and I would be able to do nothing. I would just lay there in bed, and sound and light and anything was kind of painful. And I remember my sweet daughter, when she was 8 years old, she would come in, and she would just hold my hand and sit there with me. She was very sweet, very, very sweet. And so then as the days would go by, I would come back out of it. And then at the end of 2 weeks, I would have, you know, more energy, and I could get up and move around. And of course, you start feeling better. And then they give the chemo back to you again, and you go back down. And I did that, you know, 5 times. And during about the, I think the, after the third time, during the up time, during the time when I had energy, I sat down and wrote this song because I knew I would be going away again. But I wanted to make it clear that even though I was sick, even though this was painful and no fun, and it would take me away, that this was not goodbye. I was not leaving. You're not going to get rid of me that easy, you know, that quickly. I was definitely going to be around, and I am 15 years cancer-free now, so, you know, many more to come. Yay, as my daughter claps. And so I send this out to anyone who's going through that, because really, oh my goodness, having to go through what the world's going through and having a health issue, that's got to be double scary. So, you know, much love to you all. Much strength. You know, keep those good loving thoughts in your head and in your heart, because that helps your immune system. You know, it really does. And drink lots of water. Yeah. So this is the song for you, my friends, on Easter Sunday or Sunday or whatever it is on Piano Day. It's called This Is Not Goodbye. Bravely you let go of my hand. I can't speak yet you understand. Where I go now, I go alone. This path I walk, these days of stone. And the angels are calling. I must go away. Wait for me here. Silently stay. And don't ask me why. Strength, all my desire still cannot melt this breath of fire. go to meet some kind of test. Bury the truth that scars my chest. And the angels keep calling and calling. I must go away. Wait for me. Silently stay. So much. Be strong, speak true, spread the peace, choose only love. It's a choice. You know I love you, every single one of you. Whether you're alone, whether you're with your family, whatever, wherever you are, you got a community here. You have lots of love. Reach out if you need it. Stay social. You just can have a physical distancing. My daughter and I were talking that social distancing, not the good word, because we need to be social. We are social creatures. So let's just have physical distancing, but we can be social. Call people, email, talk, you know. This is what we need to do, get through this, and we will get through this. I will see you tomorrow, 3 o'clock. Boom. Hey, daughter, can you press the end button?